day. I hope you're doing okay. Today I'm going to do a brief overview about what my thoughts are in regards to a pair of Nick's Builder Pro boots. I have had these boots, I've had them for a year. Now, in terms of aggressive using, I'm gonna say that I've been using them one day on, one day off for the past 4 months. They have seen snow, they have seen hot temperatures of the summer, and also hot temperatures at work. Now, like I said, it's been a handful of months on which I have used them every other day at a work site. And you can see the uppers are still relatively intact. There is some heel area that is starting to give in. This is due to how I walk, but there's definitely a couple of miles in them. But for the most part, they are still relatively untouched and unscathed. I do have to say that I'm surprised about how good they're holding up. Now, that is the positive aspect of the boots. Now, on a more unexpected opinion, I'd like to say that it's been awful to break them in. They are really sturdy, which is a good thing, but it's also a detrimental aspect of the boot, because breaking them in, it's really problematic. Even though they are getting more comfortable now, I still dread the idea of having to wear them, and I have to wear them for approximately 9 hours straight. It's not like I can remove them halfway through the day. So if I commit to them, I have to commit to them for at least 8 to 9 hours. So that is something that you have to consider if you have an activity that requires long hours of standing. And also, they're quite heavy, so that's also something that you should consider. Now, I am going to clean them, because I haven't cleaned them ever since I got them. I had already used a damp rag to remove the most superficial debris and dirt, which is why they look relatively clean. Now, like I said, I have not been disappointed with the boots. They are catchy. Everyone tells you, hey, nice boots and whatnot. You feel safe on them, Your heels are way protected, and you feel like your overall foot's gonna be relatively safe if you're walking on nails or if you're walking on a hot surface. You feel protected, but breaking these boots, it's been awful. Yes, at the beginning I did what Nick suggested, that you don't wear them for extended periods of time. So they suggested you start with a couple of hours and then increase the amount of hours that you wear the boots on, but I have to say that it's just been awful. Now, like I said, I already wiped them with a damp cloth, so I don't expect too much debris in there to be collected in them, so I'm gonna be really brief with my saddle soap here. I don't wanna be too assertive with it, because I already cleaning them. So if you're looking for a pair of work boots, this won't disappoint. Just make sure that you take into consideration those things that we just talked about. I hope that with this cleaning and conditioning, toss and prep a little bit because I'm planning on using some conditioning cream afterwards. So I hope that helps. As you can see, this shaft in here is still relatively thick. So only means that in terms of breaking them down, they still have a little bit to go, potentially. Make sure that you remove any excess saddle soap as you go. Now this rough out area is really, really, really taking in all of the moisture. Of the saddle soap. So make sure you wipe them as you go. But try not to be too aggressive with it because, like I said, I have already seen them. I'm also going to review the next pair of work boots that I am planning on incorporating in my work boot rotation, which would be a pair of Red Wings. Well, not Red Wings, the Irish Setter. Oops. Which are a brand that Red Wings Sales Distribute represents, owns. 100% sure how that arrangement is. Like I said, a lot of people do notice the boots, especially in the work areas, but yes, they are a nightmare to break in. So if you are planning on committing to a pair of Knicks, I would agree that they are a good investment, but make sure you understand what you're getting into as a initial observation. And also, I would strongly recommend doing what I'm doing right now with them right out of the box. Clean them and condition them thoroughly so that softens up a little bit the leather and the breaking period is not so extended. Because if not, you might endure what I'm going to, which is a very, very painful process of breaking them down. Now, that is not to say that I regret the purchase or that I think less of boots, quite the contrary. It only means that they are built in such a way in which last. It's just that it does require an additional consideration. Now, when I'm dealing with dress shoes, most of the time there are things that I can do in wet. So for instance, after cleaning a pair of shoes, dress shoes, with saddle soap, even a pair of boots, I can let them rest for a couple minutes and feel confident enough that they will be ready for the next step, which after cleaning would be conditioning. But with these next boots, I would much rather take my time. So after I apply this cell soap treatment, I will let the boots rest for a couple of hours. And I'll stop the video and then come back with the conditioning aspect of them. So it won't be a continuous video in that regard for this pair anyway. Like I said, make emphasis in removing the cells of as soon as possible so that it's not soaked up, and so that the drying process also happens faster. Now I'm using a stiffer brush precisely because they are work boots for my dress shoes and boots. I'll use a softer brush because obviously the shoes and boots are not exposed to harsh environments. Most of the time they will just it is important for you to remove the cells open, don't leave it sitting on the leather. Okay, that is it for this stage. I will let the boots dry for a minute, but for a certain amount of time, and then I use this cell soap to clean the uppers on the boots. So now what I'll do is use some of Nick's cream to condition the boots, and hopefully that'll not only help the uppers to remain healthy, but also it'll make the breaking process, which I still think it's happening, a little bit easier, as the leather might be a little bit more pliable. I will proceed to give it another brush just in case something still remains on the upper. I will incorporate the cream into the upper. Nick suggests that we do deliver small amounts in the areas near the hardware, as to avoid the leather becoming too subtle and have this fail. So that is what we'll try to do. Be cautious. Like in many other cases, I would say that less is more. So I'm not trying to go too crazy with the amount of cream that I'm delivering to the boots. But I am making sure that I cover all of the surface. I prefer a brush as opposed to a rag or a cloth because of the characteristics of the rubber. Say the bristle action would help me get the cream into the areas a little bit more assertively than a cloth. Also apply it to the sole because it is leather as well, so I want to keep that section that is exposed as healthy as possible. The addition of cream with a brush also ensures that I reach these crevices that sometimes are really hard to get with a finger or with a cloth. But because the brush hairs are a little bit longer than my finger and thinner, they can access those areas with ease. I have yet to find a general suggestion on how many times you should condition and clean your boots. I would go on a limb to say that that will obviously depend on how you use them. But I think if you are wearing your boots aggressively, perhaps once every 3 months would be enough time to clean and condition. I would say it's always common practice, suggest a common practice to at least brush the uppers to remove any evident source of debris or dirt that might tear the leather and reduce the active life of the boot significantly. So every now and then you should brush your boots, perhaps even wipe them off with a damp cloth. Make sure you reach these areas where the gusset tongue meets the lacing area. This could be an area where there could be some rupture due to dryness or accumulation of dirt. So I would say that's enough for this one. You can proceed to the next one. Might not be as noticeable, but you can see how shinier this section of the upper is. Just the basic addition of some conditioning cream. have to say I am quite interested in tasting or experiencing the new product that NYX has put out to the market, their version of a mocktail boot. It is kind of hard though, because I already have a pair. And also a work pair that is similar in terms of design. So it's a little bit complicated to justify. Buying yet another pair of boots. Separation is already occurring here. Interesting. I have noticed that. Also not unexpected, because like I commented earlier before, I do put solid use on the boots every other day. With an average distance of walking distance total of approximately 7 miles every day. So these boots have seen a fair share of walking, and they're still solid as a tank, which is very satisfying, but also a little bit worrisome, because the breaking period is still ongoing for me. Somehow it looks like this boot got a little bit more product on the toolbox area, so it. I'll treat the little kilt here. Upper application, that would be mainly it. Yes, these are work boots, but I will still use a little Zephyr wax on the edges. I want to make the color black uniform again, but also because the wax might help protect the stitching here on the welts. Stitch down construction anyway, but these boots have just because they're work boots doesn't necessarily mean that you just have to be oblivious to the small details.
I'm thinking they're looking better.
I hope they also feel better. Accelerate the adjustment of the leather components to the shape of my foot. There's nothing too bad about being pedantic. Get this section here. Part, I think we are done. I'll just release them. Call it goods. Oops, sorry. I'm not aware if I have some, if I have to, but I will let the boots sit for at least 24 hours and allow for everything to properly settle in and dry out. I wouldn't want to get a sort of debris or abrasive agent like large particles onto a wet upper or moist upper anyway, that could just end up hurting the boot. Don't need to go too fancy. I'm just gonna dry. Leather laces still look really good, so I'm not gonna replace them just yet. Which maybe you should leave in your comments if you have work boots or if you have any other type of boot. If you prefer the traditional cotton like fabric material, or if you prefer the leather laces like these ones. I definitely think that for the case of these boots, leather laces are the way to go. Anything else will just look out of place. Performance wise, though, I am not 100% sure from which one would be better material. But so far, these leather laces have not disappointed. Let me clean the surface for the presentation. So please